Quickly, we're back at it with a Sharpie. Now, you can use a pencil or a crayon, but I'm using a Sharpie to really let this come through clear. Now, basic shapes, let's talk about that. It's a gestural line, there's a triangle. Notice the Sharpie that never comes off the paper. Oval for the head, rectangle for the neck. There's another semi-triangle. Surface for the shoulders, more ovals for the arms. Gestural drawing, because I'm firing in a gesture. Look at these squiggles that I made here. I'm actually just drawing two walls to find the form of the heart of the client. See how it starts to divide the space, the eyes, the gesture. No pun intended. The legs, and besides, the artist. Showing you quickly how after my rough sketch I did another one and I erased some of my gestural lines, and now I'm finding nice linear lines that I'm outlining with a Sharpie marker to really show the contour of the Harlequins. Yet I'm still leaving some areas, such as these circles that represent the beginning drawing phase. Elbows, the base drawing. We'll be right back. Now, finding inexpensive art supplies is simple. I'm plugging staples here with these twist-up crayons, and also, believe it or not, a pack of 24 Sharpies that I got for under $20, less than a dollar a piece. There's lots of ways to skin a cat, so we're taking one of these twist-up markers or crayons. I'm going to go over and we're just going to start feathering in some of this color, just like you're working on the coloring book, into the clown's jacket. And you can do lots of things, whatever you want, and start rendering in the clothing of the Harlequins. This is the pop artist. Get in there. Okay, we're ready to start on the canvas part of this project. Pop art. So we're looking at Picasso's original. We're just going to do some fun things with the mountains, some fun shapes. And in the background of this amazing painting of the Harlequin. So we're going to just do this that represents this urn, Picasso flowers, and whatnot. It's actually one of the cubism of pop art. Now we're back and the Harlequins are all drawn in, so add a little spice, a few pom-poms on the hat, we'll come down, some buttons, and some glitter glue to make the sword. Look how fancy that is. And we're continuing with the Harlequin clown. Quick dry tacky glue. Okay, we're gonna put the backing on our Harlequin clown. You cut out some foam core. Let me see if I can do this. A little glue. Okay. Pick it up. Place it. And continue that the rest of the body. Let it dry. We're gonna flip it over. We're gonna show you how to put it on. There she is. Now, Chef can't show you every secret, obviously, so you can see I flip the illustration onto the canvas. And once you flip it, just put some weight on it so the glue really adheres from the backing of the foam core to the canvas itself. It actually makes a pretty cool composition. Look at that. And let that dry for about a half hour.